Oh gosh, yep, he is going to town here on that cockroach. Boom. And that's all it takes, everybody.
She is not very happy right now.
Holy mackerel. Oh my gosh.
Viewer's discretion. Before getting into today's video, please note that the animals seen here possess medically significant venom and should not be kept by the novice hobbyist. Attempts to replicate the action seen here or to own these animals should be considered thoroughly before doing so. I have many years of experience keeping arachnids with medically significant stings and bites, and while I'm excited to show you guys these beautiful animals, the last thing I'd want is for you to run out afterwards and purchase one without knowing the responsibility and risks involved. Please do your research and please exercise caution. Never handle these animals. Thank you.
What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another video on my channel. My name is Dion and you're watching Reptiliatus. Now friends, we did have that disclaimer because I do feel that it's very important to share that these animals require a certain level of responsibility and safety. Now we're not only going to be taking a look at the scorpions that are considered venomous, but we're going to be also looking at some species that are commonly considered scorpions, the tailless whip scorpions, and then the vinegaroons. They're not tailless, they spray acid and stuff. It's like sci-fi stuff. You're gonna see very cool animals. So if you enjoy arachnid content, feel free to stick around. I also do a lot with reptiles and amphibians. So if you're interested, definitely consider subscribing down below and dinging that little notification bell afterwards so you don't miss any of my future uploads, because I do my best to post 1 to 2 videos a week, as well as several YouTube shorts. Let's get started. Again, everybody, I want to apologize. I know that this channel has been just pumping out feeding videos, and this one's a bit more of a general update as well as feeding. The thing I'm doing here is trying to put out those entertaining videos that people like to see the animals do things like eat every Friday, while I focus on getting a bunch of big projects done, like the tree monitor build and other responsibilities I have going on throughout the week. So I appreciate your patience. I've been stocking up on ideas and footage to start creating different content that'll be again on the Tuesdays. I want to say this at the start of the video because I've been saying it at the end of the videos. I feel like a lot of you aren't watching the full videos. Be sure to stick around till the last bit of the video because that's when we're gonna introduce the emblepidgey, which is the tailless whip scorpion. It's something out of a Harry Potter movie. If you've seen Harry Potter, you probably thought this thing wasn't real. Turns out they tried to trick you. They put a real animal in that movie, made you think it was something fictional, and I'm here to show you it's not. It's so cool. So stick around till the end because you'll want to see this thing. All right, let's start with our venomous friends.
Okay, everybody. This is Achilles, my male emperor scorpion. That's the Pandinus imperator. I've had him since 2018, and he was a mature male then. So it's pretty cool to see he's lived this long. I think that's also due to the fact that I don't feed him too much. You can see the membranous tissue between the like dorsal exoskeleton and the ventral exoskeleton. When it gets kind of wide, I slow down on the feeding, and as it reduces from him going hungry, I feed him again. I don't want him to be completely bloated. I feel like that level of overfeeding would have probably sped up his life cycle and he may have passed by now. But to think that this animal has been alive for almost 5 years as a mature male scorpion is, it's pretty cool. So I really do hope I'll have him and get to enjoy him for many more years to come. It's been a few weeks since he's eaten, so today we're going to be offering him a discoid roach. I think he'll be very receptive to eat that. It'll be quite the show too. Okay, so here's the discoid roach nymph, and here it goes. Oh, he got startled somehow. Oh, here we go. Oh my gosh. Yep. Emperor scorpions don't use... Oh, I stand... Oh, he dropped it. What the heck? Oh, he's gonna grab it again. It's coming back this way. I was gonna say that emperor scorpions don't sting. They don't sting their food very often because they have this formidable strength with their pedipalps. It's very easy for them to just hold and subdue their prey. Here, I'm gonna give it back to him again. This roach. Sorry, roach. There we go. Oh yeah, okay, he's going for the sting after all. Wow, you don't get to see him do that too often, and oh my gosh. I mean, look at those chelicerae. On these guys, it's like they have a whole set of other pincers. See the stinger there? Wow, That is something else. So what a lot of people don't realize that a scorpion's tail isn't a real tail. The body is segmented and their anus is actually right here. So when a scorpion poops, it actually comes out behind the telson, which is that little bulbous end that holds the venom. So yeah, if you ever see them poop, it's like the back of their tail in that little white area. Oh gosh, yep, he is going to town here on that cockroach. Well, you got a happy scorpion here, that's for sure. And like I said, he doesn't need to eat very often, so he's probably not going to eat again for a few weeks. And I mean, this has clearly been working very well for him. He's in a bin set up, very humid environment. Nothing I really want to change for now because it's obviously working well. I have been considering moving him into an upgrade like the Megaphobema mesomelas female that I did the rehousing for. I want to do him in a bioactive too, but it's not on the list of priorities. We'll get there. Okay, very cool. See you later, Achilles. I used to keep quite a few Heterometrus salinus, but the thing about these is they're not communal or anything, and I really didn't need to have so many. So what I did is one of them was a mature male that unfortunately passed recently, but I did end up rehoming a few and just kept one because I just need one. I don't need to have four or five of these. So this is, yeah, my Heterometrus salinus, captive bred individual from my friends out west in BC, the bug guys. And yeah, we're gonna try and offer this animal a hornworm. Hey, check it out, they're drinking. That is very cool. They just ran around here and whipped around to the side and started drinking from the water dish. So there you go, if you ever wondered what it looks like when a scorpion drinks water. Okay, buddy, you want a hornworm? Should be interested. You don't actually want this? There's no way. Well, I guess not. Sometimes they just grab it when you offer it, but this seems like the animal is not interested in eating. And try once more. Well, some scorpions are eating on camera for us, and some scorpions are drinking water. So we still got to see them. So got to see some interesting behavior. Pretty cool. Maybe they're gonna molt or something. Okay, so for those of you that don't know, I keep all my most potent scorpions up here, like at the top of in this enclosure. The four of them are over here, so it's more secure and just safe. So we'll get them now and have a look. Okay, so these are my arid and much more potent scorpion species. This is a Hottentotta jayakari. We're gonna go ahead and feed the female first and have a closer look at her. Gently pick up her hide. There she is, beautiful animal. Here goes, let's give her a cricket. Hey, we got a cricket here, just a male banded cricket. Watch carefully, this all happens very, very fast. I'm gonna try and widen the angle a bit. I got the cricket moving now. I really love the Exoterra stone desert substrate. It looks so natural. It's like we're just filming in an actual desert here, you know? Gonna keep the camera on her in case the cricket bolts that way. Boom. And that's all it takes, everybody. It is wild. You have to remember, an animal like this is living in such a harsh environment, it might not be coming across prey often. And when it does, it needs to be able to subdue it right away or miss the opportunity to feed. We got some fast acting venom there. It's quite the beautiful animal. Very like caramel, crème brûlée, as I've said in the past, style of color scheme. They really are such cool looking animals. Cricket is still twitching. She's gonna have to go in for another sting sometimes when the cricket keeps moving. You can see the pectines, which are the little angel wings that drift around under the body. See those there, fluttering underneath the legs, scraping the ground? Those are one of the easiest ways to sex the scorpions is by the amount of teeth that are on those. All right, she's looking for her hide, so I'm gonna go ahead and put it back. I did wanna kinda get a shot of her eating, but I'd rather make sure she just feels secure and not worry about it. Sometimes if you just gently go, oh my bad, yep, okay, we're gonna leave her. I obviously instigated a threat posture there. Okay, perfect. Okay, so next is the male. I'm gonna go ahead and give him a cricket as well. So his enclosure has a bit of scape here. We're gonna move some of that so we can get a closer look and feed him. Again, you never ever go into this enclosure with your hands. Always use tongs. No matter how sure you are that that scorpion is hiding under the wood or isn't gonna come out, never risk it. Don't become complacent. Don't risk your safety. Okay, cricket goes in. Let's see what happens. They always just don't move, and then all of a sudden they're moving very fast. Okay, cricket, come on. Sorry. Oof, 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 oof. There we go. And so you can see what I was talking about before. See, the membranous tissue is quite spread. This guy's not gonna be fed for a while. I mean, he may very well go into pre-molt after this anyways, but yeah, we don't wanna feed him too much because he's already quite girthy. Place this wood back like that. It's not on top of him, he's under it. Place that back too. And now we're gonna go feed the Hottentotta franzwarni rice. Another really cool species in the same genus.
For today's question of the day, I'd like to ask you all, out of the three types of scorpions that we saw today, which is your favorite? Which would you own and why? Let me know in the comment section down below. As always, I'll give your comment a heart and we can engage in a little bit of a conversation. Thanks.
All right. This is my male Hottentotta franzwarni rice. Very, very cool species. Quite beautiful. Stunning legs, really nice coloration contrast wise. For the sake of trying something different, we're gonna offer him a waxworm. See what he makes of that. Not moving very fast, I'm just gonna place it here. Doesn't seem to be interesting enough to him. I'm sure he just hasn't realized it's there yet. Okay, well, we are now getting a defensive response as opposed to feeding one, so that's no fun. Well, okay, that's fine. He doesn't want to eat. I do not want to stress him out, so we'll put that back. I don't feel like having that happen twice in a row, so this animal is also just going to get a cricket. Can't go wrong with the cricket feedings. This is my female Hottentotta franzwarni rice. All right, cricket's going to go in. No way. I guess she's not interested. Well, that's just interesting. Sometimes they suddenly change their mind, so we'll give it another shot. But one more disregard for the cricket, and we're leaving it. That's a lack of receptivity for sure. Yeah, definitely not interested. That's fine. And you can see, too, that she is quite full, so she's probably not interested in feeding. Might even be in pre-molt, but at least you got to see her. They're a really beautiful scorpion. Okay, everyone. I can already see that my female giant vinegaroon, the Mastigoproctus giganteus, has completely dug up and filled her water dish. What else is new? Hello there! Look at this incredible animal. This is a really, really cool arachnid. Look at those pedipalps. You do not want to be grabbed by those pedipalps. And here we have the tail. It gives them their name. The acid spraying tail. We'll see soon on another arachnid we're gonna look at shortly. Those modified legs are actually used as sensory organs. She is not very happy right now. Look at those pedipalps. They're unreal. You can just see how they would grab and snare an insect to eat them. We're gonna see if hopefully she'll settle down a little bit and we can try and offer her something to eat.
All right, so here she is dropping a worm in. I think she's gonna feel around for it. You'll see those pedipalps in action if she does.
So I'll start digging in like that. Watch how they'll snare the food once she's sure she wants to lock in. She's not interested. I mean, she is also pretty plump, but I'm pretty keen. Still sensing, trying to find it.
All right, let's give her something small and then remove the superworm.
I'm gonna give her a silkworm. You go, little lady. You got it. She's got it. Oh, geez. Soft-bodied, healthy. You've seen a silkworm feeding video. You know why we offer these to the animals, and they're healthy for arachnids too. It's not just for reptiles.
Oh, geez.
Anybody want a little silkworm too? Oh yeah, they're sensing that. I love seeing their modified legs just feel around for prey. What is that? You got something for me? Oh, arms are out. Getting ready to snare. Feeling for the prey. Look at those pedipalps. You do not want to get pinched by those. They're feeling it. Yeah, they found the shape of the silkworm.
It seems to have lost it a little bit. There you go, you found it again. Might not be moving enough, I don't know. Boom!
Oh my god. goodness. Ooh, that is juicy. Well, better this end than what the other one did, because that was brutal from the tail. Yeah, these are fascinating invertebrates to keep as pets. And one of the cool things about them is you get to enjoy them for a really long time, because they grow super slow, at least in my experience. Well, friends, I think that was a great success.
And there you go. Those are all my scorpions.
Now it's time to unveil the special unboxing. Alrighty, friends. So this, the very special parcel. We got a heat pack here because it's snowing like crazy outside. It's still warm. Ooh, this is very exciting. I've really wanted to keep these again. I haven't owned one for years. We're talking over 10 years. Oh, I can see one of the modified legs. It's running away. So this is a species that I've never owned before. I used to have some Damon diadema, or diadema, depending how you pronounce it. This is, it says Phrynus mexicanus, but this Latin name does not exist anymore. So it's actually Phrynus whitei, or whitei. I think it's whitei. I think that's how you pronounce it. Latin names here. And this is clearly a juvenile because I had no idea what to expect here, but oh my goodness. Hello there. this animal has still got some serious growing to do. Look at that. Isn't that incredible, guys? What a cool creature. Truly something out of a sci-fi film. You can see, so the pedipalps are there, those big boxers. And it's similar to the vinegaroons, right? They have these like clubs, that these arms that reach out, they extend out, and they grasp their prey. What's different about these is that set of legs there is modified to be sensory organs. They're like these whips, and they can go around and feel for food or feel their way around tight spaces. They are very, very cool animals. Now, I want to throw you guys a little bit of a, oh, I wish we could get some more. We're not going to show you this animal setup. It's going to be a separate video, so stay tuned. Sorry, you're not going to see much more of them. I will actually try feeding the animal. I'm not convinced it'll eat in this. You know, it's a little stressed now that I've, also, sorry, my fingers are like yellow because I was cutting up squash for gut loading, but I don't think they're gonna eat like this, but we can certainly try and see. A little tong feeding. I've been surprised before. Okay, so here is a gut-loaded cricket. See what the animal does here. See if they notice. See if they're interested in feeding. See they're feeling with the pedipalp. Oh my gosh! Oh, okay. Right on. I don't know that I was expecting that. That was cool. That was very, very cool. How epic was that, everybody? You're gonna have to think of a cool name. Drop some suggestions down below if you can, please. That is so awesome. Do you see the chelicerae that are going into the cricket there? They have these really cool white markings. They just have this incredible contrast with the rest of the animal's coloration. I pointed out, we have the carapace here, the abdomen, 8 legs, 4 on each side, 1, 2, 3, and then the fourth set here, which are these long modified ones. So you would almost think these are the pedipalps, but they're not. The pedipalps are down there holding the cricket while it feeds. That was epic. Well, you didn't get to see the enclosure of the animal, but at the very least, you got to see it eat. This makes me want to get a few more of them. Oh, that is too cool for school, guys. We're gonna put them back. I'm gonna go put them in their new home that you will get to see later. And there you go. I hope you enjoyed seeing my new Phrynus whitei, not Mexicanus. Taxonomical reclassification.
Well, everybody, there you have it. I sincerely hope you enjoyed watching today's video. Thank you so much. If you want to see more content pertaining to keeping arachnids, check out the playlist up above. Otherwise, I can't wait to see you all next week. Have a wonderful weekend. Take care. See you soon.